Charles Manson was escorted from court during the Sharon Tate murder trial in December 1970. George Brich, Associated Press. Good morning. Want to get California today by email? Here's the sign up. When Scott Michaels began a Helter Skelter tour about 8 years ago, he offered it roughly once a month. Now, he guides people around the sites of the Manson family murders at least once a weekend, often selling out weeks in advance. The 3.5-hour tour is often filled with middle-aged adults who were children during the murder spree that Charles Manson, Houdy Sunday, orchestrated in the summer of 1969. There's seemingly no end to it, said Mr. Michaels, who runs several other tours through Dearly Departed, his company and museum. A lot of it has to do with the feeling that this scared us all. Up until then you thought you were safe in your own bed. The fact that the murders happened in the sanctuary of the home contributed to much of the fear that captivated people at the time, said Steve Oney, who wrote an oral history of the killings for Los Angeles magazine in 2009. It was the modern LA noir murder because Manson's cohorts butchered people in their homes, and this is a city of homes, Mr. Oney said. Until then, this was a very open city, a very porous city, and people weren't necessarily guarded. The Manson murders, Mr. Oney said, changed everything. LA went from being an embracing place to a more cautious and paranoid place, he said. It went from being a place where you went to ring a doorbell any time of day and night to an era of gated communities. It's difficult to imagine now, Mr. Oney said, but Mr. Manson was easily able to penetrate the glamorous circles in Hollywood from his perch as a street hustler, Mr. Michaels said that while his tour is focused on the historic sites, in some ways the fascination with Mr. Manson is a little less about the murders and more about the myth. Now that the man has de-will the mystique with him to California Online. Please note we regularly highlight articles on news sites that have limited access for non-subscribers. Mayor Eric Garcetti of Los Angeles says he will not run for governor, but was considering a possible run for president as a Democrat. Damian DeVar gained Associated Press. Los Angeles Mayor Eric Garcetti is openly considering a run for president in 2020. He faces tough odds. He would be the first sitting mayor elected to the White House. The New York Times, facing accusations of UAL harassment and assault from several women, where Assemblyman Raul Bocanegra said Monday that he would resign from his seat next fall. The reports about the San Fernando Valley lawmaker come as many women in the state capital complain of a culture that condones UAL harassment. The Los Angeles Times, a federal judge in San Francisco, blocked President Trump's executive order to cut funding from so-called sanctuary cities, local jurisdictions that limit their cooperation with federal immigration authorities. The Associated Press. The Republican lawmaker Tom McClintock has not faced serious opposition since he was elected to Congress nearly a decade ago. Now, three Democrats, all women, are vying for his seat representing Northern California. The Los Angeles Times. California Democrats voted this weekend to make it harder for incumbents to receive the state party's official endorsement, a change that will have its first test in the campaign for the United States Senate. The Los Angeles Times. An Uber self-driving Volvo in Pittsburgh. Uber plans to purchase thousands of self-driving Volvos for its fleet once the technology is production ready. Jean J. Puskar, Associated Press. Uber plans to add as many as 24,000 self-driving Volvos into its extensive rider-hailing network, according to a deal announced Monday, trying to ready itself for the day when self-driving cars become main. The New York Times. Want to buy a home in San Jose? You'll likely need a household income of more than $200,000, according to a recent study. The region is the most expensive metro area in the country. The Mercury News. Disneyland is no longer selling its annual pass for Southern California residents. At $469, the pass was one of the park's least expensive options for an annual pass and had been hugely popular. The move is seen as an attempt to manage the crowds at the park. The Orange County Register. Wild turkeys seem to be on the prowl in some Bay Area suburbs, and while some residents are embracing them, the large birds are not universally welcomed guests. The San Francisco Chronicle. Della Reese left with other cast members of Touched by an Angel in 2003. from left are Roma Downey, John Dye and Valerie Bertinelli. CBS' Della Reese, who played an angel on television and was an ordained minister in real life, died at her home in Encino on Sunday. She was 86. The New York Times: the Central Valley will have a new route to the Midwest next summer, with daily nonstop flights from Fresno to Chicago. The Fresno Bee. And finally, a Japanese-American internment camp in Manzana, California, in 1942. Houlton Archive. Getty Images. The stretch of the Owens Valley had been cleared of Native Americans decades before. In the 1940s, the federal government found a new use for Manzana as the site of one of the largest Japanese internment camps. It was on this day in 1945 that the camp was closed for good. While many of those who had spent years in the camp left eagerly, some refused to leave because they had lost everything when they were forcibly removed from their home years before. Some were removed by force once again. As they left, the people who had been incarcerated were given $25 and a one-way train, a bus ticket back to the towns where they had lived before the war. Today, there is an annual pilgrimage to the site which draws hundreds of people to the area. California Today goes live at 6 a.m. Pacific Time weekdays. Tell us what you want to see. CasadayAtNightTimes.com. The New York Times has dozens of journalists based in California. They will be contributing to California Today while we seek a permanent California Today columnist. Check out the job posting for the weekday newsletter here.